Welcome back to Cincinnati, Mr. Grammer.
Best ever. Favorite city.
You say that.
I actually bought a Cincinnati Reds hat that I wear sometimes, yeah. Just because I have such a good time here. Yeah.
Well, Cincinnati loves you, obviously. Let's go back a little bit. For about 3 years, you performed on the streets of Santa Monica. There were worse places in the world to perform. But yeah. What was that like? And tell people like what really happened when you were there.
It's just 3 years of really going for it, really developing your voice, your songs, and if you love music, it's still a good time, but it's a hustle, serious hustle. Getting your card out there, grabbing people's attention. Once they finally do stop, getting them to actually buy your CD so that you can pay your rent doing it. It was a hustle that paid off. It was great.
And the biggest man in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
Los Angeles, as you sing.
Yeah.
I mean, is that pretty much true to form about what you went through?
Yeah. Every day was performing at the circus. You're like, you sit up next to ridiculous people on your left and on your right. There's a balloon guy who's angry with you. There's break dancers. It's like a whole thing.
At what age did you go, oh, I want to do this. This music thing's for me.
Yeah. I started really, right around high school, started really getting into music. Listening to different albums, John Mayer, Coldplay, and Miseducation, Lauryn Hill. When those three hit me, it was like, I get music, I get why everybody's freaking out about this thing, this musical thing. And so I started writing my own songs.
And your pop, he's a children's musician,
yeah.
Really accomplished musician.
Yeah.
What does he think of Andy and what you're doing?
Red Grammer, he's loving it. He's traveled a lot, so I call him and we both know the best airport food to get, or we have a lot of commonalities between us, so he's just loving it. He's having a great time, man.
Cool. Let's talk about the new single, Miss Me.
Yeah.
What was going on in your life, or what was your headspace like when you wrote that song? What's it about?
It's kind of about, I had a bunch of friends that were breaking up, having breakups right around me, and one of them actually just broke up and had to come stay with me. And I've had breakups myself as well, and it's like, in that moment when you are the most vulnerable, when someone breaks up with you, you feel like they're saying you're a terrible person. Even no matter how they couch it, it's like, I don't want to go out with you anymore. I don't believe in you.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? It's like the biggest,
big vote.
Biggest hit to the ego that could possibly happen. So in that moment, finding strength and being like, no, you're going to miss me. So I like that. It's a little bit vengeful for me, revenge centered, but I felt that way in that moment. And it might not be a healthy thing to do, but people get through breakups by using that just as a step to get to the next place, you know?
Tell me about the video.
Video, I'm so proud of. I think it's really great. I have this line that I've been thinking of, that we're glow sticks and we can't shine until we're broken, which is a really cool idea that, like, you have to be broken to, like, come to life. So in the video, different people get broken up with, and symbolically glow sticks get broken, and it's a whole cool video. It's really cool.
You're coming back next month to the Q102 Bosom Ball. Thank you so much.
Love it.
Last year you were there, and you have a personal connection, though, and the reason you support breast cancer, you have someone very dear in your life that passed from breast cancer.
Yeah, my mother passed away from breast cancer almost about 3 years now. It's crazy. And so I'm down. Whatever we can do to help stop cancer, I'm in.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah. I really appreciate it.